All right, folks, I finished The Sopranos season 6A, the penultimate season, if you count, you know, 6A and 6B as two different ones. But anyways, we're winding down. Let's talk about it. First of all, I saw not many criticisms. I think I saw one review, and it's just stuck with me. But somebody, and most people rank season 6A at the lowest, okay? And we'll get into how I feel about that. I mean, okay, we'll get into that. But anyway, and one reason I saw was that it had no all-timer episodes. And I'm just going to absolutely disagree, because Members Only, the first episode of the season, is one of the best of the series. I watched that episode. I was mesmerized. I love that episode now, and it's great. It just does so much excellently. And then I just want to echo the point that I've echoed pretty much every season since season one, that the show has really come into its own. It's become just an entirely different thing from season one, but it never feels like it's betrayed the core values that the show had at that point, just that it's matured as the years have gone by, and this is its final form. It's also very cool to watch it retrospectively and just wonder what people were thinking as they watched it. You know, are they like, is this my last episode with Paulie? Is this the last time I get to see Junior? I don't know. I mean, stuff like that, that I obviously don't get to experience because, you know, I know how many episodes are left. I sort of have a vague idea just because of spoilers as pop culture. I mean, you kind of know some of these things just because of how influential the show was, unfortunately. And I don't know if it kills enjoyment. I don't know how I would have felt knowing that, you know, any episode could potentially be the last for a character. Certainly would have been an interesting experience. I will say this, though. This is my main comment and simultaneously complaint for this season. And that is that for the penultimate season, we're not getting anywhere near close enough to the finale. I get it. There's some foreshadowing here. It's what people like to say. It's true. I mean, I can even see it. I haven't finished the show as of recording this. I'm pretty damn close. But there's some foreshadowing. I get it. But the show is still focusing on regular plot lines that you would see in any other season. The Vito stuff. I like the Vito stuff. It's a good plot line. Even in my opinion, doesn't compare to some of the other seasons' plot lines, but it would have worked better in something like a season 4 or a season 3 or a season 2 or a season 1 or even a season 5. For the penultimate season, is this the arc that we need to be focusing on as we're closing out the show? Is this what's going to reveal the most about Tony? That last turn, that last piece of info that we need? Don't think so. And that's just my thoughts on the season in general. And really, folks, that was all I had to say. It's other than that, it's just business as usual is how the season feels. It doesn't feel like it's at all the penultimate season to The Sopranos. And for that reason, it's going to get a B from me. The Sopranos season A is going to get a B. Still fine television, still good television. There's no bad season of The Sopranos, for God's sake. But as far as seasons of The Sopranos go, this is definitely one of the more lackluster ones. All right, folks, that's my review of season 6A of The Sopranos. If you're a defender of season 6A, let me know. I'd love to see a bit of discourse, but that's my opinion. The finale coming soon. Season 6B, and then The Many Saints of Newark, the movie that I'm grateful for coming out. Even if it sucks, it got me to watch this show. So it already holds a special place in my heart for that reason alone. All right, folks, I'll see you. Season 6B review.